Now, the most important sales document in Microsoft Dynamics Nav is a sales order, because from a sales order, you can ship items, you can invoice sales orders, and so on. However, the sales order is not always the first step in a sales process. So a typical sales process can start with a sales quote or blanket order. So a lot of customers, before they actually decide if they want to purchase an item or service, might ask for a sales quote. And based on the sales quote, they will then decide if they will actually purchase the item or services. Or you can also have a blanket order. Now, based on these documents, you'll see that we can convert them into orders. So based on the quote or blanket order, I then can create a sales order. Now the sales order can be shipped. So if we're selling items to customers, you'll see that we need to ship the items if they're available to the customer. And that's something we will do by posting the shipment. Now posting the shipment will create a postage shipment document, and this will update the inventory, which means that my inventory will decrease and the items will be posted from the inventory. We will also invoice the item to the customer, and that will create a posted invoice. The posted invoice will also update an item, so in case, for example, the price of an item on an invoice should be different from the shipment, you can have additional value entries on the item, and the chart of accounts will be updated. So based on all the posting groups that I have set up in the system will post on the GL accounts. Another thing that posting the invoice will do is update the customer card. Because from the moment the invoice has been posted, the customer will need to pay the invoice. Now, if this is actually done, you will see that we can record the customer payment. And this will update the customer card and will, of course, also update the chart of accounts. So this diagram shows a typical sales process in Microsoft Dynamics Nav. And let's examine these different components a little bit more in detail. And let's start with the sales quote because, like I said, the sales quote in a lot of cases is the very first step in a sales process. So let's have a look at a number of these features in the system. So here in the application, because I'm using the sales order processing role, I can go directly to my sales quotes. And here's a sales quote that I've already created. I've entered a quote for the Canon Group, which is already a customer. If you are working with a prospect, you wouldn't need to create the prospect as a customer for the quote. You are able to send a quote to a contact. Most of the fields in a quote are not yet that important, because your customer might not know if they want to actually purchase the items or services that you're offering. So these fields typically will become more important in the sales order. For this quote, I've entered in 5 Seoul guest chairs as an item and a resource of 3 labor hours from the employee Mary. So everything is exactly the same in a typical sales order. But again, this is still in the sales quote. So when everything is entered, you have the ability to print the quote. You can also use the email function. So if I want to directly email the quote to my customer or to my contact, I can just click on email. I can then click on make order. And you can see now that my quote can be converted into an order. Now, in my case, my quote 1001 has been changed to order 1040. And as you can see, the quote is now removed from the system. Now, if I open my list of sales order and search for the sales order that got created, and here it is. On the right navigation pane, you can see a bunch of details pertaining to the customer and sales line. I'm able to see how much quotes, blanket orders, orders, invoices, and so on that we've created for this customer. If I were to select orders, here's a list of open and released customer orders for Canon Group. On the right navigation pane, I'm also able to see customer statistics. This is a great overview of the sales to your customer. The system retrieves most of this information automatically from the customer table. If I were to click on balance, I can see the due date of outstanding invoices. The invoices that are red are overdue invoices. Now let's go back to the sales order. You are also able to view when an item is available or not. This is a great way to let you know what items you have available on hand. The inventory can automatically be updated in connection with the sales if you're going to change the numbers. So for example, right now I have 5 Seoul guest chairs. I can see I require 5 of them. My item availability says I have 86. But if I were to change the quantity to, let's say, 10, you can see my required quantity has updated to 10, and my item availability has changed to 81. As you can probably tell, all the tables are related, and information in the field is copied from one place in the system to another, so you'll only need to enter information once. In addition, you can change information on each header line if you need to. Now let's post the sales order and email the invoice. This dialog box attaches the document together and allows you to write a short message and send this email directly from Microsoft Dynamics NAV. To view what transactions took place, would be best to look at the customer card. So if I pull up the Canon group, and in the right navigation pane, if I click on Posted Invoices, here I'll be able to pull up the invoice we just created. And if I click on Navigate, I'm able to see all the related entries of this transaction. I can see my GL entry, my tax entry, customer ledger entry, detail customer ledger entry, and so on. I'm also able to drill down and see what GL and posting groups have been affected. And now that you've sent the customer your invoice, you're now waiting for payment. And that concludes processing of sales orders in Dynamics NAV. Thanks for watching.